Welcome, I'm Astrid Neuenhaus of the Environmental Resources Center at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. In this video series on agroforestry, our topic today is alley cropping. I'm with Mark Shepherd of New Forest Farm. Hi, Mark.
Hello again.
In Viola, Wisconsin. And Mark has been working for years with different crops used in an alley cropping system. Do you want to tell us what alley cropping is all about?
Sure. Alley cropping is the planting of rows of trees, whether for timber, fruit, or nuts, and growing a crop in between, in the alleys in between rows of trees, in order to cash flow while your trees are maturing. Your trees obviously are a longer term investment. They take longer before they mature. Mm-hmm. And so plant your trees in rows, and while they're growing and maturing, plant something in between. And behind us over here, we have rows of chestnut trees with sunflowers growing in the alleys in between. You can use almost any crop or any tree in an alley cropping situation. Some considerations you want to take into effect are what's your soil types, the rainfall regime where you are, your equipment. If you're growing corn and have a 6-row corn planter, you wouldn't want to put your rows of trees five rows apart. So what we have here is, the idea here was this for to be a chestnut orchard. A typical chestnut orchard would have trees planted 30 feet apart, which these chestnut tree rows are approximately 30 feet apart. And then you sit around and twiddle your thumbs for 15 years while you wait for them to finally start to produce chestnuts. Well, we did it in an alley cropping situation. This is sunflower grown between the rows of chestnuts. The sunflower is primarily a biofuels crop. The seeds will be harvested this fall and pressed for oil, sold to a potato chip company, and then the oil will be recycled from the potato chip company and used as fuel in tractors.
Oh, nice.
And the meal from the sunflowers will be used as animal feed.
Now, the sunflower is an annual, and I know you like to work with perennials. So, do you have another crop that's a perennial?
Yeah, I actually really do like growing perennials, especially because you plant them once and you're done forever. This planting of a crop every single year kind of drives me crazy, but that's okay. And actually, right down the hill here, I have an example of a perennial crop grown between rows of chestnut trees.
Oh, great. Let's take a look.
All right.
So, Mark, this is the perennial crop asparagus that you're using as the alley crop between the rows. Do you want to tell me a little bit about this system?
Sure. We have approximately 2 acres of asparagus on our farm here, and it comprises 4 different beds that are big, long horseshoes that go around this peninsula here. And once again, the rows of chestnut trees are approximately 30 feet apart with the asparagus growing in the alley in the middle.
But let's talk about competition, because most asparagus growers that I know would keep the soil surface bare, and I see that you have grass growing there.
Right, we have grass and a lot of white clover is growing in there as well. And we have to kind of venture off into a little bit of my own personal economic philosophy, in that most growers, yes, they do either till the soil or use herbicide or mulch to keep the weeds suppressed in the asparagus. Well, in my personal perspective, mulch, herbicide, and tillage are all inputs, which means it's a time or a money expense.
Right.
And so why not cut that expense out and take what we get for the yield? Because remember, once again, I'm establishing a chestnut orchard here. That's my prize, is this chestnut orchard. And then I drive around a lot and I see wild asparagus growing on the side of the road. Nobody ever planted it, and they plow it, they don't fertilize it, herbicide, fungicide, cultivate. Nobody does anything to it except go harvest it. Well, why can't I do the same thing with my asparagus here? And that's what we do.
And then how do you keep the tree from basically taking nutrients from the asparagus crop?
Well, there's a technique that agroforesters use. Agroforesters call it root plowing. A nurseryman or a gardener would call it root pruning. We have a device called a subsoiler, which is basically a big hook that we put behind our tractor, and we drag it along. Every spring, I'll put the subsoiler on, and I'll drive immediately next to the row of chestnut trees and drop the subsoiler, so the roots of the trees in the row can't get out into the crop to steal nutrients. They have to stay within the row, and it encourages them to go deeper.
Root pruning.
Also, those deep slots allow water to soak in quicker. If my soil can absorb 1 inch of rain per hour, and it rains 2 inches in an hour, The other stuff sheets and just gradually oozes mm-hmm. away. With these large slots on either side of the asparagus bed, all that water pours down into the ground and it soaks in from a deep level, so we're able to store water at a deep, deep level in the soil.
And root pruning also encourages more fibrous roots of the chestnut trees, so that's beneficial as well.
And with the root pruning, you have to start in the early years with the plant. If I wait till the tree is 15 years old and go by with a hook and rip the roots mm-hmm. off, you're going to cause all kinds of damage, encourage decay in the roots. You want to start as soon as a tree is little, even when you don't think that it's important. You have to start the root pruning at a very early age.
So these are younger trees. Do you have a more mature orchard section that we can look at?
Sure. These are about 10 years old. Uh-huh. They're starting to produce really nice crops of chestnuts, not quite a full crop of chestnuts. If you'd like to see what a more mature system looks like, we can go down the hill still further and see a 16-year-old alley cropping situation.
Oh, let's do that.
Chestnuts. All right.
These are really pretty catkins, Mark. And look at all these nuts coming. So this is a more mature chestnut than what we saw up above?
Yes, this is about a 16-year-old chestnut tree.
And to me, this doesn't look like alley cropping. Are you still alley cropping here?
This is still alley cropping. That's how this started, is this was rows of chestnut trees at the same spacing as we saw up in the asparagus, mm-hmm. and we grew zucchinis in between. Mm. And as the trees matured and their branches started to come out across the alley, we reduced the number of rows of zucchinis that we grew until there was only one in the middle.
Oh, right.
And by about that time, we started to notice elderberries showing up as weeds underneath the chestnut trees. So we replaced the zucchini with a row of elderberries going right down the middle between the rows of chestnut trees. So now this is alley cropping with elderberries between chestnuts.
Are there any other, other than the elderberry, any other fruit that grow in the alleys?
In the alleys, what has started to show up as weeds are mulberries and raspberries and grapes. So when we see those show up as weeds, what do you think we plant? We plant more mulberries,
oh, yeah.
raspberries, and grapes. And what we also noticed in the shade of the chestnut trees is that gooseberries and currants would show up. And so I started to plant red currants underneath the chestnut trees. So now this alley cropping system in this chestnut orchard has chestnuts and currants and elderberries and grapes and mulberries and raspberries.
That's delicious.
Yeah, very
Thanks for inviting us to talk about alley cropping.
Thanks for coming out.